Doggy. Yes. 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 It's afternoon. The sun is sinking into the west. I haven't been looking at the moon, but I'm still leaving the telescope out just in case. He's here by the cement pond. It's a sunny day, although there are some clouds up there, as you can see. Here comes an airplane. Yeah. Drifting through the sky, looking towards the airport. Actually, it has to turn the corner. Oh, maybe it's not going to show up. It seems to be moving in that direction. Well, it's been a quiet week here in Lake Laurel Canyon. I had planned to go to a friend's house for Thanksgiving, but just didn't feel very good. My hip has been bothering me, and with a little bit of rain we had, it got even worse. And then my tummy got... something got wrong, and I had the runs the night before, so I had to cancel. I decided I wanted to just stay home and rest. I regret it now, because it would have been a good chance to catch up with not just my friend, whom I see every couple of weeks, but with his wife and with their son, who's was an unexpected baby. They were in their 30s and 40s when he was born. And he's now in his middle 20s, carving out a career for himself. He doesn't want to work in offices. He likes working it in the outdoors, and for a couple years now he's been guiding groups of tourists on packaged luxury camping tours into the national parks. And I was looking forward to chatting with him about the different parks he's been to, because I still have on my bucket list a chance to, if I get my hip replaced and I can walk better again, I've been thinking about driving to some parks and maybe even staying overnight. And not a lot of hiking, but you know, a couple hundred yards from the parking out to the view spots, which it's a big thing now for me just to walk down the short hill to the mailbox without my hip bothering me, which it does almost every step I take. But one day I might be able to walk a short distance without much pain. Maybe if the dog is still with me, I'll take her out on my trips. Excuse me. So it's been a long weekend, pretty quiet around here. Nothing but houses in this neighborhood. They did some tree cutting nearby. I could hear the saws winding away in, here in Laurel Canyon. And And I'm looking up at the tree right now. It's out there. Its branches moving a little bit in the wind. They say we're going to have some breeze for a couple of days and then maybe some more showers, which means my hip might be starting to hurt me again. Well, it always hurts a little bit, but sometimes it gets pretty bad, usually when the weather gets wet. I'm wearing a sweatshirt and sweatpants right now because it's sunny and the sun is warm on me. I can feel it. But except for the sunlight, it's not very warm. It's dropping towards cool. Tonight, the temperature will be down in the 40s, which here in San Diego is considered freezing. I know some of you have had real frozen weather, not like the fake California frozen weather, but as he strokes his mustache. But in the 40s is cold enough for me. I even wear sweatpants and sweatshirt to bed. I don't want to run the heater. This big house burns up a lot of natural gas just to get the temperature up out of the 50s. So I've got the windows open. There, you can see over there, they're open. See that? The windows are open. Trying to let in the mild, I almost said warm air, but it's not really warm, it's just mild. Get some of it in the house during the day, and then I close all the windows at night, and it usually will keep the house 10 degrees above whatever chill it is outside. So I'm hoping when I wake up in the morning, it'll only be in the 50s indoors, even though it'll be in the 40s outdoors. That's about all that my life is about right now. Oh, except for the poetry contest I'm working on. A manuscript of between 48 to 100 pages of poems. Only one poem per page, please, or if it's a longer poem, it can take multiple pages, but they don't want two short poems on one page. No, only one poem on a page. So I've been working on that, and the deadline is in the first week of January. And I'm almost got the manuscript ready for a final review and then maybe cut some of them out, because I have like 110 pages now, and 100 pages is the maximum. And that's the item I forgot to mention, was working on those poems and watching my poor old dog. I think she's having some pain now. Maybe she reacts to the cold weather just like I do. I let her sleep inside at night even though she's incontinent. Oh, that's the other thing. That's the bad thing, is the doggy poops on the floor at night. Yeah. Well, the carpet is 20, 30 years old, so we're going to have to rip it up anyway, but just the same. It stinks. Yeah. She's a pretty girl, though. And she seems to be fond of me. And I'm fond of her. And if I have to put her down, it's gonna hurt. But then she looks up at me and I go, well, not yet. You're still pretty good. It's hard for her, but then it's hard for me, too. So, hear the car going by out there. It's afternoon, Monday. Monday, the 27th. Is that what it is? Yes, it's the 27th of November, which is the 66th day of winter in the Northern Hemisphere. And the 15th day of the moon. Oh, the moon was so full last night. I got up in the middle of the night to go pee, and everything was outside was filled with silver light. Beautiful. Even though I had to crank open the bathroom window to, because it's one of those frosted glass things, just to see outside while I was peeing. Not so bad in the bedroom because the window doesn't have to be cranked open. It's just a big plate glass window that looks out in the yard. Right out in that yard over there. Yes, it does. It looks out into that yard where the oak tree and the bougainvillea is. And that's what it does. Yeah. I hear my neighbor yelling across the street. I just heard him yell in the house. I don't know if he was talking to the dog or to a kid. Yeah. It's pretty quiet around here in Laurel Canyon, outside of San Diego.